Happy birthday, Age of Z Origins. As I told you guys, I was about to do a video talking about this event that is occurring in the game, and today is the day. I couldn't pass on this event for two main reasons. The first one being that there is literally a cake the size of any buildings in your game directly, as you can see in your city, which looks kind of strange with a big three on top of it because it represents the 3 years old of the game. But also because of the juicy reward this is gonna get you every time you click on it one time per day. Just take a look at that. For example, here I got an elite teleport fragment and some food crate as well. What is great about this is that the game is spoiling you. Every 1 hour and 44 minutes you have the possibility of clicking on that and getting some pay to win rewards completely for free. But even if the design is beautifully executed, there is something a little bit more interesting than this. Just click on this icon right there you're seeing, and oh boy, not only do you have one, you have actually 4 events. The first one is the login for gift. All you have to do is logging in every day pretty much to get this purple officer called Alexandria. And yeah, it's literally one of the greatest officers in the game for literally nothing else than just logging in every day for 7 days in a row. Nothing too hard to do. But the most interesting part of the event is not located into the game directly, but rather on the Age of Z Origin YouTube channel. From there, you have the possibility of taking a look at the brand new update and especially their plans for the upcoming year. And trust me, it's juicy. So there we go, guys. The third anniversary gala revealed is here. And oh boy, after the loading screen, are you gonna be amazed? First thing first, we have the upgrade to cities. Back in the good old days, when you had the city hall to the level max, which was 31, you couldn't do that much, besides maybe creating troops and fighting off, but pretty much nothing else. Now you have the possibility, and you're gonna see it, to increase to level 38, which is a big change because, oh boy, is it already really hard to get to level 31. So just imagine having your city getting to the level 38. This is just insane, and I'm really looking forward to see what it will look like when I will be myself able to get a city that looks like this. Now let's keep going with the second thing that is mostly awesome, the fact that we are going to be able to get level 12 troops. Back in the days we had level 11 that I'm going to highlight right after, but still, this is just amazing because just take a look at how dope they look. It looks like they're out of the future. It's not like they are afraid of zombies, it looks more like the zombies are afraid of them, which make them this just awesome. And there are plenty of them. Not only one or two new troops, but a whole new 6 troops, including the biggest zombie. Now, of course, we have the mighty thank you, or yeah, the thank you message. And boom, that's it. Here you see Alexandria, the new commander you can get completely for free. But this update highlights a huge question, because obviously on the bigger server where everybody is already big, getting to level 38 and getting the level 12 troop is not going to be a problem because they're all gonna make it all together. But in smaller servers where you have a huge gap between the average player and the big fishes, then yeah, it's going to be problematic. And I'm glad that for you, I have the perfect example of what I'm saying. What I mean by that is that as a new player, I'm only at level 6 when it comes to my troops, but there are people in my server that already unlocked the 11 troops and much more. And those guys attacked me 2 or 3 weeks ago, if I'm not mistaken, and I got attacked by the number 1 player on my server called Big Mama something. And yeah, you're gonna see, I'm gonna launch the video replay and you're gonna understand truly how horrific that thing is. I'm getting completely wrecked. For instance, the blue guys right there are my troops, and I got completely annihilated because what am I supposed to do against tier 11 troops? Nothing. And so maybe in the future I'll have to literally bubble myself all day long in order to avoid getting wrecked by those new troops. Because the bigger the gap between your level of troop and the level of troop of the attacker, the bigger your losses and the less losses the attacker will suffer. For example, right there, Big Bad Mama only lost 15,000 power, whereas I lost nearly 550,000, which is, yeah, 1/3 of my total power since the day I started. So in the end, the only solution I found was to bubble up, because when you're bubbling up, nobody can attack you. And unfortunately, I wish it could not be like that, but I don't have the choice, guys. I don't have the choice because I'm still a small player, and in order to catch up with the bigger players, I need to grind. And grinding takes a lot of time because it's a city building game, and as every single city building game, it takes time to get where you need to be. Now, of course, I have something special for you. If you want to get something juicy in order to start the game correctly, you can always use my code. You download the game through the link in the description, and when you're in, just click on my info right here, then settings. From there, click on redeem gift and put the name of the channel right there. Click on exchange and boom, you're gonna get yourself some juicy rewards to start off your adventure. Tell me in the comments, what do you think about the level 12 troops? Is it gonna change something? Is it gonna make the smaller servers really hurt or not? And I'm gonna see you soon for a new video about... we'll see.